Hey there, it's Matthew Rayfield from Matthew Rayfield Worldwide with a tutorial for you on using your 3D printer as a 2D printer. Well, actually as a pen plotter to move a pen instead of 3D printing. You know what I'm saying? You take a vector, convert it to Gcode, all that jazz, and I couldn't find another tutorial online about how to do it, so I'm making one. Here we go. What you need to do what you're seeing right here is you need to start with a vector. And here's the thing I'm going to print today or draw or pen plot today. It's a little dude that I drew. I've got him as an Adobe Illustrator file. If you've already got an SVG, you can skip this step. And if you don't have Adobe Illustrator, but you got a vector, you can use something like Inkscape. You don't have to do much here. Right here, all we're doing is going to clean this up, which I've actually already done. So I had some paths in the layers that I didn't want to print. And even though they were hidden, they still show up when you convert to Gcode. So you just want to delete those. Second thing you need to do is something that I didn't know until yesterday, is you need to make sure that this is on the basic brush. Because if it's on some kind of fancy brush, your 3D printer, after you convert it, is actually going to trace the outline of the line, the perimeter of the line. Like if you have a big fat brush, it's going to trace that whole big fat brush rather than just doing one line for it. And right now we just want one line. The brush thing might be cool. I haven't really messed with it. But for now, just basic brush. Convert it all to basic brush. Once you've done that, you got to export it as an SVG. Why didn't that work? What's going on? Export as. Oh, okay. SVG. That was weird. SVG. Gus, SVG. Put on my desktop. Boom. Done with that. Okay. Next step is you need the software to do the conversion. And that software is LaserWeb. LaserWeb is free. I'll put the download in the description, download link, but if you Google it, you will find it. It's available for Windows and Mac, obviously, and I guess probably Linux too. But once you've installed it, I'm assuming you can figure out how to do that yourself, pull it up, and we're gonna go to settings. This is just the one-time setup. You wanna go to Gcode, Gcode start, you wanna basically enter these settings, I think. But this is pretty standard. That's already there. You're just basically telling it use millimeters, use absolute positioning, and then home, go to origin, and then move Z to 10, which is that's marker up. So that's really the thing that you need to definitely do here is the tool on and tool off. My settings are Z5 is marker down and Z10 is marker up. I do that so that the nozzle is not in any way, shape, or form touching the paper. And you might want to change that if you want it to go higher or lower. Obviously, you change it. So, but tool on, tool off. And again, this laser web is made for laser cutters, to generate G-code for laser cutters. So instead of having a laser that turns on, we have a pin that moves down. You know, so that's all we're doing here. And I'll have a link where you can see this stuff in more detail, but you could just copy it right here. And that's it for that. That's really all the setup you need. There's some other settings you could tweak, but it's not necessary. So now we've got that going. I'm gonna add my SVG. And so go to Gus here, Gus SVG. And you'll see it doesn't look right. And that is the first problem. If your LaserWeb makes this SVG look fine, then you're good to skip this next step. But if it looks like this, it looks messed up or messed up in some other way, I have a potential fix for you. I made a little tool called Matt's SVG Fix Tool. I say fix in quotes because it's kind of a hack. It basically is taking curvy lines and making them into lots of little straight lines. For some reason, LaserWeb likes that better than some of the paths that are generated by various things. So if you have that problem, you just pop it in here. The left is the unmodified, the right is the modified version. It should be fine. If it looks weird, mess with that number on this page. That changes how many lines you have. But if it looks good, just go to download. Download that, good to go. go back into your laser web there and go ahead and add the new corrected SVG. Okay, see, now we're looking good. So what you want to do now is make this, size it to your printer bed and set the lower area, the minimum X and a minimum Y. I have it 50-50, 50 millimeter, 50 millimeter. That's not the edge of my bed, but it's safe there. That's what I do. It's not optimized. You tweak it for your printer. Okay, so once you got that, pop it down here to documents, and now we're going to go to cut rate. I have cut rate right now in millimeters per minute. You can change it per second, which is a little more comfortable for the 3D printer world. But I'll just do it like that. And then that's the only setting you need to change as far as that. Then click generate. And definitely click generate, because if you don't click generate and you save it, you're just going to get blank G-code. It's pretty cool like that. So once it's generated, hit save. And now we're going to save the G-code. I've already got some G-code. We're going to save the G-code on my SD card. That's how I get it to my printer. However you get G-code to your printer will work. And now, before we head to the printer, you need a way of attaching the pen or marker or whatever to your printer. I made this little bracket. This bracket works for me for the Anet A8, and I actually use a rubber band, you'll see it. But I use a rubber band to attach the marker to this little bracket. You could literally just tape the marker to your printer, to your printer carriage. But if you want, if you feel like you're feeling fancy, like I was, although not that fancy because this is kind of a piece of junk, but hop over to Fusion 360 or your CAD of choice and make yourself a bracket. And I'll have a link to this STL and the Fusion one if you want to modify it or whatever. Okay, so now you've got a way to attach it. Go ahead and pop on over and attach your paper to your printer. I use some binder clips. I've also taped it down. Really doesn't matter. However you want to get your paper to not move around. And then you're going to go to this little bit of G-code that I wrote called position, which is just going to move the printer into a place where I can then insert the marker so that that is the marker down position. So that's Z5mm. And so here I go, attaching it. You want to adjust this rubber band a little bit. You might want a little bit of tension on the marker so that it kind of pushes down on the paper. You don't want it to be too light because you'll get not good lines. But you don't want to be too tight either, or too tense, because it'll just skip. So you fiddle with that. And then you go to your G-code and you print it, and it prints. I say print, I mean, it's not really printing. I don't know what the definition of printing is, but it's not printing like a traditional printer. It's really drawing. And I think it's a lot of fun. I've been using it to make stickers, and what I think is cool is you could really print on anything and with anything. All kinds of markers that are fancy gold markers or whatnot, or print on cardboard, or print on plastic, or print on the top of your laptop. It's possible. So I hope this was a good tutorial. I hope you learned something. I've got a tutorial link written down tutorial on my website, and I'll put that link in the description. And yeah, that's it. Adios. Oh, hey, I'm not gone yet. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, I'd really appreciate if you give it a like. And if you want to see more content like this and see what else I'm up to, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. It won't hurt you. And also check out MatthewRayfield.com. That is my central hub of all the stuff I'm working on. And hope to see you again. Later.